you're never gonna waterproof a basement from the inside. The best thing to do is manage water, and the worst thing you can do is trap it in there. Philadelphia has a ton of row homes that were built in the early 1900s, the late 1800s, and they're beautiful, solid, amazing buildings that were built to a lot better standards than we're building today. Unfortunately, they weren't designed to be used as living spaces. So what everyone ends up trying to do is seal up the basement and create a dry space, and that's in a lot of ways incompatible with the materials that were used to originally construct. When we started this project, we're in South Philly. We're at this remodel on the whole house, and we're clearing many safety violations. We are getting the basement ready to build a finished basement. The stone walls when we got the building were parged and crumbling. They used a really hard, impermeable Portland cement-based mix. And after about 15 years, the Portland started failing. It wouldn't let any water pass through, and it was coming off in like 2-foot sheets, so we were pulling it off. It was compromising the foundation. It turned all the existing mortar that was holding the stacked stone to essentially dirt. So we removed all the Portland cement, and we parged it with materials that we got from a company called Lancaster Limeworks. We used their H1 binder, which it actually used to make hempcrete. It's a specialty blend of lime. And we used sand and water, and that was it. We pretty much everywhere the basement is white is where it's parged with the lime mortar that we used. And we did about a 10-foot section with Portland for two reasons. One, it was a side-by-side comparison. This is gonna be a property that we own and continue to manage. And the second reason is we ran out of the lime mortar. So we chose the area where it was least susceptible to moisture to do this experiment. But I don't know if you can hear this, but see how hard that is? Pretty cool sound, and that's coming off. And a lot of people don't like seeing that when they parge a basement. They think harder is better, harder is stronger. But the reason these basements and these buildings lasted for so long was because they're permeable. They were able to breathe and dry out. This lime will, you know, it's starting to crack a little bit too. We need to put a little skim coat on some areas. It will let moisture pass through. It's soft enough to move and have little tiny movements and absorb them. When you do that with Portland cement, it will crack, it will come off, it will trap moisture behind there, and hydrostatic pressure will build up and it will cause more of it to come off. It will deteriorate the mortar into the stone, and people end up ruining their houses and causing major, major issues by trying to parge this with something that you can get at Home Depot. And it's one of the hardest things to do is to convince people that, or convince different tradespeople that you should be using a softer product, because the homeowner sees, you know, not many people want to see you scratching with a 150-year-old nail and having dust come off, but that's what is kind of best for the building, is to let permeability and moisture and movement get absorbed and passed through. This, you know, it seems strong, but it's not compatible with the way the rest of the building was built. So our plan for finishing this basement involves treating the slab, or what's going on under the slab, and the walls. So we have a new slab. There's a bed of drainage gravel underneath, anywhere from 2 to 4 inches. It should be a little bit more, but you know, to keep the ceiling height, we did 2 inches in some places. Maybe we cut that part out because it's not ideally perfect. But we have an upgraded product here. It's a Stego 15 mil vapor barrier. It's super thick, durable plastic that's pretty hard to poke through. But what we're gonna do is bring our vapor barrier on the walls, tuck it behind there, so any moisture that comes through the walls, any bulk water that comes through the walls, is gonna be kept on the back side of the vapor barrier and fall under there. And under the slab, we have a perimeter drain. It's made of corrugated plastic that is perforated. That runs along the entire perimeter. It's dug down about 6 inches and it's filled with gravel. So any water that comes up from the slab will find its way there. Any water that comes from the vapor barrier will find its way in there. It will go around the perimeter into a sump pit in the corner, and it will be evacuated from the building. You're never gonna waterproof a basement from the inside. The best thing to do is manage water, and the worst thing you can do is trap it in there. So this is the plastic that most homeowners use for under slab vapor barriers, and it really doesn't do anything. There's no, up until now, there haven't been any residential specs for what, how thick of a vapor barrier you need, but this stuff, you know, it rips like that. This is a 15 mil vapor barrier. It can stand up to masons walking on it. It can stand up to, you know, tools being carried on it, stuff being put on top of it, and it's not gonna degrade. Concrete is very caustic or very basic, and it really degrades plastic. So you can see videos and pictures of this stuff after a couple of years, and it's essentially non-existent. So we are gonna try to work with Stego about getting some more information. Stego is the manufacturer of this vapor barrier, about getting some more in-depth specs, and we're hopefully gonna be doing a video with them about why you should invest a couple hundred extra dollars on a dry and radon-free basement.
Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you on the next project.